हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज आवर सेकंड वीडियो रिगार्डिंग द यूनिट नंबर सेकंड, दैट इज द प्लांट डिसीज फर्स्ट। एंड इन दिस प्लांट डिसीज फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट अबाउट द ग्रीन ईयर ऑफ द बाजरा। वी सी द सिम्टम्स, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द सिम्टम्स। इन दैट द कॉब इट इज लुक लाइक द लीफी अपेयरेंस और द ग्रीन ईयर अपेयरेंस। अलोंग विद दैट द सिम्टम्स ऑल्सो शो on a pistil as well as the stamen, the leafy appearance of the cob. After that we see the causal organism. The causal organism is Sclerospora germanicola, and there the systematic position or the classification of this and the structure of this causal organism. After that today's lecture we see the disease cycle. This fungal spore, it is the soil-borne disease. Soil-borne, it means that this fungal spore present in a soil and it can be survive near about 3 to 5 years. Therefore, it is the soil-borne disease. Along with that, it is also present in a plant debris like roots, remaining roots, stubbles, leaves. Along with that, the oospore, the structure of the oospore, it is survive in a soil near about 3 to 5 years. The germination or the disease cycle, it can be completed when the favorable condition is present. The oospore, it is germinate to produce the germ tube and which infect the seedling. It means that the favorable condition is also present, and for the germination of this oospore, it produces the germ tube, and with the help of the germ tube it infect the seedling. It is the small stage, or it is the juvenile stage of the bajra, and the seedling it is mostly affected. And the secondary infection, it is takes place by the sporangia. First infection, it is takes place with the help of the oospore, and secondary infection, it is by the sporangia which produced the zoospore. It means the sexual life cycle is completed and it enters the leaf stromata and cause the infection. This is the disease cycle. We see the two types of the reproduction is present, that is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. But the firstly, this causal organism, it can be infect the leaves. On the leaf surface there is a brown color spot, or initially this spot it is whitish in color, later on it get convert into brown in color. Then this fungal spore, it enter into the leaf stromata and the mycelium is produced, and this mycelium it produces the sporangiophore. This mycelium, it is produced a sporangiospore, and this sporangiospore, it is dichotomously branched and it produces sporangia. This sporangia, it is present on the stigmata. We can see that. After that, this sporangia, it develops into the oospore. Okay, this is the oospore. It is the encystate. After that, it produces the zoospore, and this zoospore, it is the kidney shaped, biflagellated. This flagella, it help in a movement. For the movement, this flagella help for the migration of this zoospore. This flagella play an important role, and after this zoospore, after some time, this flagella is lost and it become the zoospore, and this zoospore, it forms the germ tube for the infection. This zoospore, it forms the germ tube for the infection, and this germ tube, it is again infected the new plant of the bajra, and this cycle, it is again repeatedly done. This is the asexual reproduction. Okay, I can repeat again. Firstly, this fungal spore, it is enter with the help of the leaf stromata, and it show the first symptoms shown on the leaf surface. There is a whitish color patch on seen on the leaf surface laterally turns into the brown in color. After that, mycelium enter and it forms the sporangiospore. It forms the sporangia. This sporangia, it forms the zoospore. Zoospore, it is biflagellated, and it, after the development of this zoospore, it forms the germ tube. And this germ tube, and with the help of this germ tube, this zoospore again infect the another new plant of the bajra. Yes, this is the asexual reproduction cycle of the asexual reproduction. After that, the sexual cycle. This mycelium, firstly it infect on the leaf, then again same the sporangia is produced. After that, this sporangia, it produces the male sex organ, it is called as antheridium, and female sex organ, it is called as oogonium. Male sex organ, antheridia; female sex organ, oogonia. And this antheridia, it produces the fertilization tube here. The fertilization tube is produced, and with the help of this fertilization tube, it insert into the oogonium or in the egg, and the gametangel contact is takes place, and it forms the oospore. Okay, mycelium is produced, oospore is produced, oospore produces antheridia and oogonia. Oogonium, female sex organ; antheridia, male sex organ. And after the development, it produces the tube like structure in antheridium. It is called as fertilization tube. This fertilization tube, it insert or it penetrate into the oogonium, and there is a gametangel contact is takes place. And after fertilization, it forms the oospore, and this oospore, it is enclosed in a double layered wall for their protection. After that, this oospore is break this wall, and again the oospore, it is migrated to the healthy normal leaf, and cycle is again repeated. This is the sexual cycle of the green ear of bajra. On favorable condition, a sexual reproduction cycle is completed, or sexual reproduction is completed. Which condition is favorable to that causal organism, or both the cycle is takes place. This is the asexual reproduction and this is the sexual reproduction. Okay, after that, the control measure, how we can control this disease, or we can use the different types of the, we can use the chemical treatment along with that some other treatment to avoid the infection of the of this disease. In that, the next point is control. How to control? First control measure, that is the sanitation. Sanitation means if we see in a field the infected plant at that time, or we see the infected leaves at that time, we can remove the leaves and infected leaves, destroy them by burning. Or if we can see the infected cob, at that time we can remove it and it can be destroyed by burning. This is the first control measure, that is the sanitation. Okay, second control measure, it is the crop rotation. Crop rotation means we cannot grow same crop again and again. We can break it. It means that we can rotate the crop at least 5 years. It means that if we can sow the bajra in this year, then next year we cannot be grow. That is the, we can rotate, or it is rotated another crop like jawar or kharib, it is rotated with rabi. After that, avoidance of monoculture. We cannot grow bajra on year after year. It means that the avoidance of monoculture. After that, we can give the seed treatment or the chemical treatment. It means that we should use the appropriate fungicide like thyroid, ceroson, aggreson, etc. We can seed treated with the proper fungicide, the thyroid, ceroson or aggreson, it is the name of that fungicide, we give the proper treatment. Along with that, the important control measure, that is the use the disease resistance variety of bajra. We can use the disease resistance variety of the bajra like HB hybrid bajra 5, PHB 10, PHA 14, etc. Control measure. What are the control measure? First, sanitation. Second, crop rotation. After that, avoidance of monoculture. After that, use of proper fungicide. Then, disease resistance variety like HB5, PHB10, and PHB14. This is the whole regarding the disease cycle along with how to control the green ear of bajra. How to control? This is full life cycle. In this, we can see that is the symptoms of this disease. After that, the causal organism and their systematic position. After that, the structure of this causal organism. Then, how to cause the disease, the life cycle, that is sexual reproduction as well as asexual reproduction. Along with that, the control measure. How to control the disease. Okay, this is in this way we can complete our first disease, that is the green ear of bajra. And in next video we start the second disease of this unit number 3. Thank you.